Hui. Aloha mai kako. Welcome back to hula. This is our Tuesday night hula class. And sorry, I scared myself again. This is our Tuesday hula class. We have been covering Makee, ʻAilana by James K.E.E. And we have done two verses so far. At one point, I thought we were going to try to cram in two verses today. But luckily, I checked the calendar and we have three more weeks, including today. So it will be perfect to do one verse each week. So phew, if you're, you know, gearing up to have a crazy one, don't worry. Today's just going to be one more verse of Makee ʻAilana, along with a nice review of verse one and two. I'm very excited to present to you the newest mu'u to my collection. I actually bought this one. I didn't rent it. Some very good friends of ours are the owners and operators of ʻAilana Sportswear, and they are actually turning the page to a new chapter. So for those of you that are familiar with ʻAilana Sportswear, actually maybe I'll go grab a couple more of their costumes while I play the intro video, but they've been around for many, many generations, actually, and they have been outfitting Hawaii's finest in aloha wear for a very long time. They've decided to move on to other things, and they're going to stop their apparel line. And so they announced today that they're doing 50% off everything in store and online. I'm not sponsored by them. In fact, I think I sponsored them a little bit today with all the costumes that I picked up. But I encourage you to go check them out. They're dear friends of our families, and we really wish them the best in their new endeavors. This is my newest acquisition from them. It's a mandarin collar, sleeveless, mu'umu'u. It's full length, nice and flowy, and it even has pockets. So anyways, also thank you to Wendy for my lei. This is a pua keni keni Tahitian variety, so I wish you could smell all the things going on. It's going to be a fun day. I feel like hula. So without further ado, I think it's time. All right, that was sort of last minute. I just ran into my closet to try and find a few more. But if you've seen this dress or the blue and white costume that my ladies wear, these are all from ʻAilana Sportswear. Really, really high quality garments. I just wanted to do one last plug. ʻAilana Sportswear, go check them out. 50% off. You really can't go wrong. And who doesn't need more hula costumes? This girl, probably. Anyways, before we jump into hula, I want to say hi to those of you that are joining us live. Of course, we have our replays always available. So if you're watching the replay, mahalo for being here. I wish I could say your name out loud, but I don't know everybody who's watching the replays. But I want to say aloha to Beverly, who is joining us from Kelowna, BC. Let's see. I have to pull up my thing. For some reason, it doesn't always show all my comments. Yeah, actually, I don't know who else. Can you show them up? Veronica is joining from Mexico City. Aloha, Veronica. Who else? Do we have anyone else? Oh, of course. Sharon is joining us from Halawahale, right here on the island of Oahu. And we have Michelle Vaughn. Aloha. I truly feel the aloha being sent from all around the world. Hayato, aloha avakea from Japan. It's nice to see you joining us live today. You always catch our replays. I know that's awesome. We also have Julie Zydek, who's joining us from Hong Kong. She's originally from here, but it's nice to see you, Julie. And let's do maybe two more. Carol, of course, Mama-chan. Just woke up from a nap. I wish that I had just woken up from a nap, but we were busy running around. One more. Let's see who else is here with us. Adrian Woods joining us all the way from Florida. Aloha mai kako. Thank you for being with us today. Of course, as always, we're coming to you live from Nu'uanu Valley right here on the island of Oahu. it's kind of a hot and muggy day, but we really can't complain because I know all around the U.S. it's like sweltering hot, and elsewhere, I'm sure. So thank you for taking the time out of your day to be with us and to join us for Hula. So, oh, yes. So if you're asking about the ʻAilani sportswear link, Luke, my hubby behind the camera, he put it into the chat or the comments, and it's actually pinned right at the top of your comments. So you should be able to see it there. Should I say it out? What is it? ʻAilani? ʻAilani.com. ʻAilani.com. I believe that this dress is normally like $90-something, maybe $95, $90. And I think I got it for $45, which is just ridiculous. Really a steal. They have lots of sizes available, so definitely check them out. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for considering that. Okay. So now we're going to jump back into our hula, Makee ʻAilana. Makee ʻAilana, of course, is written by James K. E.E., but it is in honor of an island. Now, it's not like Maui or Oahu, Kauai, one of those major Hawaiian islands. It's actually kind of a tiny island that used to exist here on this island. So if you were to go down near Waikiki, Kapiʻolani Park area, actually there wasn't a park there at the time. There was no zoo. And right where the zoo is now, the entrance to the zoo, there was a little tiny island. Let me show you a map I think we have. Yeah. So this map shows you where the island is. You see the red arrow down on the bottom. That's where Makee ʻAilana was located. And Makee ʻAilana was named for Captain James Makee. I told a little story about Captain James Makee, but maybe we can show his picture. There's Captain James Makee and his family, who lived part of the time here on the island of Oahu, part of the time on the island of Maui. He was very instrumental in the development of Kapiʻolani Park. But because he was so influential in the area and he was a boat captain, the island in the marsh down at that spot was named in honor of him, Makee ʻAilana, also known as Makee's Island. So that island was a favorite place for lovers to go. They would go on a date on a rowboat and they would have to row there. Maybe we have a picture of that one. There we go. Oh, I think, yeah, that's the one that I wanted to show. So you see, we have the lovers and their rowboat, and they had to really take a trek to get there. But once they got there, it was like a secret island for secret trysts. And so this is a love song about a special place for lovers called Makee ʻAilana. So let's do a quick review of verses 1 and 2. I'm going to do a really fast review, and then we're going to do a little bit of basics that I need you to know before we get into verse 3. Okay, so for Makee ʻAilana, we're going to start by drawing that island. So your hands are going to come right here by your, we're dog sitting, and the dog is just a little bit, Oliver, you want to say hi to the people before I send you away? Here's Oliver. He is not part of the show today. Goodbye, Oliver. Okay, and we're back. Okay. So Makee ʻAilana is an island in the marsh. You're going to bring your hands right here by your hips, and you're going to draw that island. Now, this looks like a circular island, but we're going to move our body forward and back so that we can make that long island of Makee ʻAilana. So for that, you're going to kaholo imua and ihope. Makee ʻAilana. Then you're going to place your hands down to the land, and you have one ka'o there. Ke aloha, of course, means love. You're going to bring your hands to your cross and then open. After you do that, you're going to turn towards the left wall. Aina means land, so you're going to bring both hands parallel to the ground. Aina I ka'ehu, the sea spray. You're going to wave to the side. That's the right and the left, and then the right and the left. As always, I am mirroring you, so go ahead and follow my hands just as you see them. So we're going to kaholo imua and ihope. Ready, step forward on the right, go. Makee ʻAilana. Then push down. Ke aloha. This is akaholo. And then turn to the side. Aina is going to be a o. Aina I ka ehu. Forward and back. E-hu-o-o-ke-kai. Try one more time. Look beyond the hands. And Makee ʻAilana going forward on the right. Makee ʻAilana ka o ke aloha la. Turning toward the left wall. Aina I ka ehu. Ehu o ke kai. Side, front, side, and front. I know that was a super, super fast review. For those of you that are just joining us for the first time, don't be discouraged. You can always go back and watch the replay of week one from this week or week two if you want to review the next verse. And we spend quite a bit longer just reviewing that one verse, okay? So if that was like, I didn't get any of that, don't worry. You can always go back and watch the replay, okay? So that was verse number one. Let's try just verse one with the music and see how we do. Okay, so this is my re-recording of Makee ʻAilana. Of course, I don't use the commercial recordings because that would be copyright infringement. So I always do my own re-recordings, but I do highly recommend that you use one of the beautiful versions. We particularly like the Brothers Kaz version, but there's so many good ones out there. So just look up Makee ʻAilana. You'll find some good ones on iTunes or Spotify, wherever you listen to music. So for our intro, you're going to start with four ka'o. Ready, ka'o. Kaholo, side front. Makee ʻAilana. Turning side. Okay, so that was your very quick review of verse number one. Now let's do a review of verse two. Poku elua. So elua means two, and it is verse two. That's a good way to remember what verse is coming next, two and two. So for after you finish your vamp to the right and your vamp to the left, this is going to be your right hand that goes from the side to the front. You're going to continue it on and make the number two. And it's right about 45-degree angle at shoulder level. Yeah? So you're going to push across. Elua. Then ekolu means three. So there were two or three of us. So going from this side. Elua ekolu. Of us, you're going to flip the palm over and you're going to sort of reach out. Then you're going to gather all of your friends with the left hand. It's going to make a big circle around. And then pull it into your chest. Then you look side to side, like you're surveying the people. Did we get everyone? Yeah, we did. Okay, so elua ekolu, going from number two, ready, number two. Elua ekolu of us, no mako. Then look side to side. Ika ʻAilana ma hie hie, you're gonna do this land motion. So you're gonna push with the left hand across. This is more like hip level. So parallel to the ground, and then right hand, parallel to the ground. Ma hie hie means charming, so you're going to lift your hands up. It's like, oh, this land is so charming, so cute, this island, okay? So that's ʻAilana ma hie hie. Let's just do the hands again from the vamp. Ready, side and front, side and elua number two. Elua e kolu of us. No mako. Look side to side. Now that cute island. Ika ʻAilana ma hie hie. Lifting the hands just there. Okay. The feet work for this starts out simple and gets progressively harder throughout the verse. So for elua ekolu, we're going to kaholo right and left. Let's do that part. That's easy. Ready. Going to the right. Elua ekolu. No, no mako, you're going to step forward on the right, and then you're going to pivot around and side kaholo to the left, kaholo to the right, and then ka'o, ka'o. Okay, so that's a little combination that's a little bit tricky. I'm going to lift my ʻAilani sportswear mu'u mu'u for you to see my feet just a little bit. And we're going to show you the feet in this view, and then I'll show you in the Vavai cam. Okay, so we're going to do that. No mako is going to be a lele forward on the right. And then you're going to turn, pivot. The left foot is going to side kaholo. Left, right, left, together. Then we get a regular kaholo to the right. Kaholo to the right. And then ka'o, left, right. Okay. So now let's try with the vavai cam so you can see the feet a little bit closer up. So we're going to step forward on the right foot first. Sorry, that's this foot right over here. Ready, step, no. Then pivot on the left. Ma-ko. Then holo to the right. And ka'o, left, and right. Okay, try one more time without the slow tempo. Let's go regular tempo. So let's go from elua ekolu. Start with a kaholo to the right. Ready? And holo to the right. Elua ekolu no ma ko ka'o. One and two. While we're already here, let's just go over the feet next because it's going to be a lele uwehe. And I already had somebody write in and told me, this step is too hard. You have to practice. Okay, just kidding. Okay, so next part is gonna be lele uwehe. Step, point, together, uwehe. Well, what does that look like? Uwehe goes like this. That's it. Then we're gonna go to the other side. Step, point, together, uwehe. Okay, so that's all of that beat that's gonna come together. So let's go from elua ekolu, just the feet, and then we'll add the hands. Ready, holo to the right. Elua ekolu no ma ko ka'o ka'ailana mahi e holo left. I forgot the holo left. Okay, let's come back up. So now we're going to put it all together with hands and feet. I know this one's a little tricky. That's why I did the review a little bit slower. So starting with the number two, we're going to kaholo towards the right. Ready, holo, right. Elua e kolu, one step. No turn. Mako, bring it in. Mako means us. And then looking side to side. Ailana is the island. Step, point, together, uwehe. Step, point, together, uwehe. Lift for charming mahie hie. Okay, let's try up to tempo. Da 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 dum. Elua. Number one. Two. Elua e kolu. No ma ko ka'o. Ika ila ana mahie hie. Ba da 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 dum. How was that? Any questions? I know that one is tricky. Again, if you want a longer explanation of just that second verse, definitely check out the replay for week two of this month. That was the 8th, I believe, June 8th, okay? So here we go. Second verse, Elua Ekolu with the music. Number two. Verse 3, which is what we're learning today. Okay, so before we go on, let's try a review of verse 1 and 2 with the music, and then we'll kind of slow it down, I promise, for verse 3. Okay, here comes verse 1 and 2. Ready to ka'o four times. Lift the hand to the waist. Makee, ʻAilana.
Makee, ʻAilana ke aloha.
Love motion. Turn. Aina is the land.
Aina
in the sea spirit. Look beyond the hands. Makee, ʻAilana. James Makee's island that is so beloved. It is the aina or the land in the ehukai, that sea spirit. Elua, number 2. All of us, there were two. Gather all your friends on that island. Lele uwe his step. Point together, uwe his step. Point together, le. Follow.
Kaleo.
That's it. Okay, so don't forget, you can always go back to the replays to practice those first two verses with a slower tempo. You can also check out, we're on Instagram, and I did a reel of just the first verse. Actually, just today, one of my dear, dear friends, Kanoi, posted a video of her dancing with me side by side. So if you use Instagram and you know how to do all of those fancy things, I would love to see you dance with me. Or if you just want to post it, then I will dance along with you. I would love to do that as well. So let's go on now to practice a couple of basic steps. So verse 3 is called Kaleo Kavai. Now, leo means voice, but we're not talking about a human voice. In this case, we're talking about the sound of water, which is funny because we have an aquarium behind this wall and I can hear it going trickle, trickle, trickle. That's Kaleo Kavai. That sound of water kind of bubbling or whatever, babbling. Babbling brook, you know what I mean. So anyways, the sound of water is kaleo kawai. In Hawaiian, they often will give human characteristics to inanimate objects, although actually water is pretty animate. So kaleo kawai. But the feet motions for that is going to start off simply with kaholo. Thank goodness, right? Let's double check that our kaholo is really, really nice and even. So when we do that kaholo step, I know we've been doing it a bunch, but make sure that first step, the distance here, is about the same distance as that second one, okay? So we don't have a big and a small and then big and small. Let's try to the left. Ready, holo, left, together, left, tap. Right, together, right, tap. Left, together, left. Tap, kaholo. Are you doing it with me or am I dancing by myself? You better be dancing. Kaholo to the right, 2, 3, and left, 2, 3. Okay, so for kaleo kawai, you're going to start pretty simply with kaholo. Now, kaleo o kawai ka'u aloha. Okay, the next part is going to be lele. And so for lele, it's going to be a step. Now, there's different ways that you can do a lele. In this one, it's going to be very simple. It's just kind of like stylized walking. So you're going to step to the right. There's a little swing of the hips. Step to the left and step to the right. I know that feels weird, but there's only going to be 3 lele. For now, let's do 4 steps forward and 4 steps back with a nice sway in the hips. Not like how you would walk normally, but a little bit extra oomph. Okay, ready, set, lele imua, right, left. Right and hoppe, stepping right and left. And let's see the vavai cam going forward. Lele, right and left. Right and left and back. Right and left. right and left. What you don't want to do for your lele is to do like a step, tap, because you get this little bounce and it's not smooth. So you want to make sure to keep your feet separated and you're just going to really drag it. It's almost like a ka'o step, but you're just moving forward on the ka'o and then back. That's going to be your lele. Imuo meaning forward and ihope meaning back. Okay, let's come back to the regular camera. So now let's try this. We'll do a combination of kaholo and lele. Kaholo, of course, being the basic step, lele being forward or back. So I'm going to say imuo or ihope, and you follow along. Okay, so here we go. Ready? Kaholo, right, go, right. And lele imuo, four times. Here we go. One, two, three. Now stay here. Kaholo in the front. Two, three, tap. Lele hope, step back. That's a right, left, right. One more time. Kaholo to the right. Two, three, and left. Lele imua, step forward. Two, three. Stay here. Kaholo to the right. Two, three, and left. Ihope, stepping back. Right, left, right, and left. So generally in choreography, if you have steps that take you forward, you also have something that takes you backwards so that you don't fall off the stage, right? Okay, so that's the next step. The next thing that you are going to need to know, of course, is just a ka'o. I probably should have started with that, but the ka'o is just going to be a nice, smooth side-to-side motion. So like the lele, but you're not moving forward and back. Let's see. Oh, okay, the last one that you need to know, this one is a little funky. It's called the Oniu, Oniu, or sometimes it's called the Ami Oniu, okay? For the Ami Oniu, I should have made a graphic or something to show you, but the Oniu is going to be like a figure eight or an infinity sign, yeah? So you're going to go like this, but instead of just having the sign go this way, you're going to take that whole sign and you're going to put it on the ground. Okay, so now your hips are drawing the infinity, but it's going this way, and then it's going to go that way. Always starting towards the front first. So let's start. Bend your knees down. Your right hip is going to push towards this front angle, and then pull back towards that back corner. Now your left hip is going to push towards that corner, front corner, and then towards the back. So instead of just a straight ka'o to the side, you're gonna get this oniu, which is a figure eight, swiveling this way. Okay, I'm gonna turn to the side so that you can see the difference this way. On a ka'o, you would just go straight side to side, 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 side. On the ami oniu, it's gonna look like this. Forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. Okay, one more angle that I can show you. Hopefully this overhead cam, maybe this will help you just to be able to see from a little bit different angle. So for the ami oniu, again, bend your knees down. You're gonna push towards that right side first. Ready, here we go. Forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. Ami oniu, right and left, right and left. So for this choreography, we can come back to this camera. For this choreography, we're actually going to do it in the cuckoo beat or the triple beat. So instead of just going slowly, 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 it's actually going to go quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. So for those of you that do ballroom dancing, maybe that's a familiar rhythm for you. But for your ami oniu cuckoo, put your hands across your waist and we're going to go, I'm sorry, your chest, and you're going to go quick, quick, slow. Ready, set, here we go. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. And for those of you that took my ipu class, that beat is that cuckoo beat. So with the ipu, it's going to sound like this. Ooh, ooh, ute-te, ooh, ooh, ute-te. So that's going to be your oniu cuckoo. It's going to look like this. Ooh, ooh, ute-te, ooh, ooh, ute-te. That's a quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. Okay? Just so that you can know where that comes from. That's why it's called ami oniu. Ooh, Ami oni o kuku. You don't want it to go for a roll there. Okay. So that's the last step that you're going to need. We just need to do it to the right and to the left, and then that's it. You're not going to do it over and over and over. But that's the ami oni o kuku. Got it? All right. I'll show you how it fits into the choreography right after that. So here's verse number 3. Our verse 3 talks again about the sound or the leo o kawaii of the water. So remember, we're on an island and, you know, we're with our loved one and maybe a few friends, and we're just surrounded by quiet and the sound of the water. So your hands are going to bring your middle fingers are almost touching, and they're right here at your lips in the center. So it's going to come straight forward. Kaleo. This one is just about mouth level, but then it's going to come down. O kawaii. You're going to come just about pico level, belly button level, and you're going to do a wave in the center, and then you're going to bring your hands out to the side. Okay? So try one more time. I'll move so you can see my hands. Ready from your mouth. Kaleo kawaii. Yeah, there's really only one dip in the center, and then push the hands out versus a dip and a dip. No dip on the outside. Okay? Mouth out. Kaleo kawaii. Then ka'u aloha. We've kind of done this motion before, but you're going to bring your hands up to cross and then front. Okay? So you're going to bring that love, gather all the love, bring it forward. Now, remember we said we have some friends there. So you're going to gesture to the right, then you're going to gesture to the left, and then you're going to come to your center. So you're going to kind of share the love. Share the love, and then bring the love back to you. Very important in Hawaiian that we don't always give, give, give. We have to take some of the love back, okay? So here we go one more time. Kaleo kawaii, the sound of the water. Ready, and go. Kaleo kawaii, ka'u aloha, and right, and left, and in. So there's no words for that. It's just kind of like an extra fa la 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 la, something like that. Okay. I wanted to point out that it does say kaleo o kawaii as opposed to kaleo o ke kai. The word vai with a W refers to fresh water. Kai with a K refers to salt water. And they did mention kai in the first verse when they talked about ehu kai, the sea spray. But when they talk about the water that surrounded Makee ʻAilana, they're talking about vai with a W, not a V, with a W. So we know that it is most likely fresh or maybe a little bit brackish, but mostly fresh water, which is kind of cool to note. Okay, so kaleo kawaii, one more time from your mouth. Ready, and mouth out. Kaleo kawaii, scoop up. Ka'u aloha. And left and in. Okay? Now, ika I mai he anu kaua. Now, it's not only saying that the water has a voice, but now it's speaking. Ika I mai. To I is to say something. Kind of assertively. I mai is not just olelo or ha'i, but I mai is kind of a pointed. It's saying something to us. Ika I mai he. Anuka'ua. So when we hear the sound of the water, there's a little tingle or a chill in the air. It makes us have that sort of whoo, hui hui, very like a cold, cool, but pleasant feeling. Anuka'ua. Okay, so ika'i mai, after you hear, yeah, you're going to bring your left hand. You're going to make like your pointer is going to extend a little bit, and you're going to bring it right to your lips, and you're going to push it this way. Okay, so it's not just olelo, like all your hands, fingers like this, but it's one finger. It's almost like it's telling you something. Then anuka'ua, you're going to bring it right here, and you're going to float it right in front of you. Now, anu anu means to be cold. Now, I think this is a nice kind of chill. It's like, ooh. Snuggle up close to me because I'm cold. That kind of anu. Anu ka'ua. Okay, so last week somebody had asked me, do we actually touch when we do this? And I mentioned that I don't usually actually smash. There's a couple of reasons. It doesn't look pretty. Also, I'm wearing this beautiful lei and I don't want to mess it up. But normally I will have a little float. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm not crushing my lei. Even though we're saying, oh, it's so cold, you just have to kind of give that feeling without physically hugging yourself or going, brr, okay? So, more than you wanted to know. Okay, let's try kaleo kawaii from the mouth. Ready, mouth out. Kaleo o kawaii is what we love. Ka'u'aloha, out and in. Ka'i'i mai he. Anu ka ua, and then you vamp. Da 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 dum. O kaleo from your mouth. Kaleo o kawaii. Ka ua aloha. Right and left. Ka ii mai he. Anu ka ua. Now wear this. This motion just kind of stays for a long time. The difference is that your head is going to do the moving. So you're going to look over this shoulder and over this shoulder. I think that's the correct shoulder, but let me add the feet and I'll tell you for sure which way to look. Okay, so let's add the feet to this. For kaleo kawaii, we're going to start with kaholo. Remember I said we're going to start simple. So kaholo to the right. Ready, here we go. Kaleo kawaii. Ka'u'aloha. Now here's our lele. Step left, step right, step left. Okay, so try one more time. You only get three lele there because it's kind of that funky beat. Kaholo to the right first. Ready and kaleo, here we go. Kaleo o kawaii. Scoop it up. Ka'u'aloha. Step one, step two, step three. Okay, now ka'i mai, when you're doing this pointed motion, even though the hand is going forward, remember that I said when we do some choreography that goes forward, we need to move back. So we're going to do a kaholo and we're going to move back. Let me show you the vavai cam so I can show you what that looks like. For the lele, we already ended, sorry, with our weight on the right foot. Your weight is on the right foot, your left foot is behind you. We're going to holo back on the left foot. So it's going to look like this. One, two, three, tap. Okay, so that's going to be your imai. Let's start again from the lele imua, stepping with the right foot first. Ready, step. Right, left, right. Holo back. Left, right, left, tap. Okay, so come back to see the hands with that. So let's go from the stepping forward. It's going to be side, side, front, and then on the holo back, this is your one finger, we're moving backwards on this, okay? So step forward, right, ready, step, right, step, left, step, right, holo back, e mai, okay? That's what we're gonna do right there. Ka e e mai he, then anu, you're gonna bring your hands here. Wait, I have a feeling I messed it up. Hold on, I have to dance the whole thing. Kaleo, ready, holo to the right. Kaleo o kawaii, ka'u'aloha, step and step. Ka'i'i mai he. Oh no, I didn't. Okay, anuka. You're gonna face towards this angle. You're gonna look over your right shoulder. And here's your ami o'neil kuku. Right, left, right, left, right, left. That's the whole thing. Then your vamp is gonna just take you, stay to the side, and then turn to the front. O kaleo, here we go, from the mouth. Kaleo o kawaii, ka'u'aloha. Step right, step left. Ka'i'i mai he, anu ka'u'a. Holo side, then turn front. How was that? It's a little tricky, I know. The timing is hard to kind of work it all together, but if you keep on practicing, you'll be fine. So let's try it now with the music, kaleo kawaii. This one, you have to give a little bit of that sass over the shoulder, because when you say anu kawa, it's like, I'm cold. What you gonna do about it? Okay, ready? Sassy, you got it. Ready to hula? Kaleo kawai. The voice of the water is what I love. Kaleo kawai.
Kaleo kawai.
Love motion. Step right, left, right.
Anu ka.
I put the wrong hand on the outside. Don't do that.
Ina o you.
Okay, sorry. I'll explain to you what I meant. After you do this imai, this hand that is extended is the one that goes to the outside, okay? The same e mai is the one that goes on the top. And the reason for that is it has to go back out for your vamp. So it has to have clearance to move. So after you do e mai, don't do what I just did, which was try and slip it underneath, right? Just path of least resistance. After you e mai, bring to anu, stay here, and then it's clear to go for your vamp. Does that make sense? Yeah? Okay. Good. So let's try one more time, just the third verse. Then what we're going to do is second and third verse. Then we're going to do first, second, and third verse a couple of times. And then that's it for today. Okay. So here is Kaleo Kawai. If you have any questions, by the way, feel free to type them into the comments and then Luke will let me know if we have any questions. Here's Kaleo. Hello.
Kaleo.
Anytime we would end a verse facing towards a side, the first vamp that you do would always stay there, and then the second vamp was going to be the one to move. Now that I said always, it's probably not always, but most of the time. If you're facing to the side, stay there for the first vamp, and then turn on the second vamp. Okay, any questions? Okay, so let's try now the second verse, which is Elua Ekolu, going into Kaleo Kawai. We'll take baby steps moving us backwards. Okay. Elua Ekolu. Good luck. Second verse.
Elua.
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 There were two or three of us couples. Look side to side on that island. Lelewehe. Is charming. Good. Second chance of that second verse.
Elua. Elua ekolu no mako.
Ka'o. Lele kwehe.
Ailana mahie.
And vamp. Here's our new verse.
Kaleo. Kaleo.
Questions. What is your question? on the lele imua, are your arms beckoning or just presenting? That is a great question. I have to dance it because I don't know. Kaleo o kawai ka u aloha. Bum, bum. I don't think that they are really beckoning. If they are, it's not gigantic. It's really more like acknowledging and then coming in. It happens so fast that I think if we tried to deliberately put a wave or a beckon in there, it would look messy. You know what I mean? So this part, kaleo o kawai, there's this little wave here, but my hands are actually pretty still. It's the arms that are doing the work here. And then it just that way, and in. Yeah, otherwise it's going to look too like aerobics or something. Okay, so that's my final answer. If it looks like I'm beckoning, then I don't know. I might be. I just have a tendency to make waves where I said not to make waves. So, okay, good question. Very good question. Keep them coming. Okay, let's go back to, do we dare go all the way back to the beginning? Yeah? So we're going to go all three verses from Makee ʻAilana two times, Elua Ekolu two times, and then Kaleo Kawai two times. You got this. That if you ever decide to dance this song with live musicians, for some reason, musicians have a hard time remembering more than four verses. Sorry, all you musicians out there. When you go to dance this song with live musicians, be sure to check with them which verses they plan on playing, because usually they can remember the first verse and the last verse, guarantee. The middle verses, especially when there's more than four, get a little mushy. So you always want to check with live musicians. Okay, okay, what are you going to do? You're going to do Makee ʻAilana, and then you're going to do Elua Ekolu, and then how about, do you know Kaleo Kawai? And then they might go, oh, babes, I don't know that one. Okay, never mind, skip that one. Then we're going to go Haʻina. Okay, So the way that you talk to musicians, you just go with whatever they know, right? Just go with what they know. And then you're going to check how many times they're going to do each verse. Because sometimes they do it two times, sometimes they do it one time. Because you're going to dance, you want to dance it as many times as possible. So if you can, go 2-2-2-2-2. That means two times of the first verse, two times of the second verse, two times of the third, two times of the fourth, two times of the fifth. If you don't want to be up there that long, then you can just go 2-1-1-1-2, right? So that's the slang. If you're talking to them, you say, oh, yeah, I only want to do first verse, third verse, last verse, and we want to go 2-1-2. Sometimes because I'm a kumu and I'm just kind of lazy, sometimes I say, I want to do first verse, third verse, last verse, and I just want to do 1-1-2. whatever you like to. Anyways, I just thought I'd point that out because I have danced this with live musicians before, and they often forget Kaleo Kawaii. That verse, that middle verse is just lost sometimes. So just a tip, pro tip, make sure you check with live musicians before you dance. Okay, but this is a recording, so it's not going to forget. Let's do all three verses, and this time I encourage you to practice your kahea, calling out the verses. You can do it. Here we go. All three verses. I think we have time to do it two more times. So this is, we did one, this is two. Why I went on that rant about which verses and what. So the version of this hula that I really love to dance to is the Brothers Kaz version. And I think it's on one of their best of CDs and then maybe one of their previous ones. But the Brothers Casimiro, of course, Robert and Roland, recorded this song. And I think at the beginning of it, it sounds like two voices that I'm very familiar with, which is Manu Boyd and Ekela Kaniopio Crozier. And they're sort of playing the part of the two lovers. Maybe next week I'll give you a translation of what they're saying so that you can kind of understand that conversation. But the reason I wanted to point it out to you is because the Brothers Kaz have an instrumental version in their song. So as a hula dancer, you get to choose. If you're going to dance to the Brothers Kaz version of this recording, you get to choose which verse you dance during the instrumental. Or if you're a really nice hula dancer and you're dancing with live musicians, if they really insist on doing an instrumental pa'ani in the middle of your hula, then you can just step to the side and say, take it away, Robert, and roll in. But if it's a recording, that looks kind of dumb, so don't do that. Okay, so the instrumental verse on the Robert and Roland version, you can choose which verse you want to. And I'm interested. Of the three verses that we've learned so far, Makee ʻAilana is verse number one, ʻElua ʻEkolu is verse number two, and Kaleo Kawai is verse number three. If you had to choose which verse that you would do for an instrumental version, let us know in the comments which one you would choose, verse one, verse two, or verse three. Informal poll, just wondering which one is your favorite so far. Okay, enough talking. Let's dance for the last time, verse 1, 2, and 3 of Makee ʻAilana, and then we'll be back next week to learn another verse. Here we go. Last time, no hints. Beautiful, beautiful job. I want to congratulate you. This is not an easy choreography, but you're doing a wonderful job keeping up. Be sure to watch the replay if you need to practice. I think I said it earlier, but I do want to thank one more time. One of our wahine came by just about, I don't know, half an hour before hula to drop off this beautiful lei. I know it looks almost as big as like a plumeria. It's actually a pua keni keni, but it's a Tahitian style. So this is from Wendy Chang. Thank you so much for outfitting me and making me smell so delicious. And yeah, we're really, really blessed to have all of these friends who take such good care of us. And especially for you folks that are out there watching, we're very, very appreciative. And you are why we do this week after week. So thanks for being with us. Thanks for all the love and all of the questions. Those really help. So don't feel bad about asking questions. We really love those. So I think that's it. Keep practicing. Until next week. Ahui ho.